Hi everyone, Sebastian Zuck here from TU Bergakademie Freiberg. I want to introduce you to some new Python modules for analyzing student activities in a GitHub classroom. The team in Freiberg designed and implemented these packages with our partners from two other German universities, Humboldt-Universität zu Berlin and Otto von Guericke Universität from Magdeburg, as part of the DIP-IT National Research Project. We generated this material with LIA script. The content as well as the package repositories you can find under the given links. Let's start with some background information and concepts. Afterwards, we directly jump into practical examples.
GitHub Classrooms are an excellent way to teach students about the features and use of project management tools and version control. You define a task in a repository, and a clone is created for individual students or a group after their login. Afterwards, they work independently on the given task and commit a result. This can automatically evaluate it by pattern matching or test methods. However, depending on the size of your course, supervising students' activity becomes complex. GitHub Classrooms provide some mechanisms for exploring repository progress, but these can only answer specific questions to a limited extent. As a result, you click from student repository to repository and aggregate the results manually. GitHub to Pandas closes this gap and allows the automatic aggregation of repository data like commits, issues, or pull requests. The collected information is stored either in Pandas data frames or in CSV files. The collected data is anonymized by GitHub to Pandas and can be evaluated as a feedback for the instructor. The sequence diagram shows the aggregation phase on an abstract level. It uses the two Python modules prepared by the team. GitHub to Pandas implements the actual data aggregation from one repository, while GitHub to Pandas Manager coordinates the survey across multiple repositories in a loop. The user specifies his requirements in a YAML file and passes it when calling the program. The demand definition may contain lists of repositories, but also patterns and search queries. In addition, the user defines what kind of information, commits, issues, workflows, etc., should be collected. Finally, GitHub to Pandas Manager identifies the relevant repositories and collects the desired data set for each of them. In the end, the information is saved as a Pandas data frame or a CSV file. I took the following exemplary configuration file from the package documentation. Starting in line 1, it references a project name and the data root folder. In this package, the aggregation selects relevant repositories according to white and black patterns applied on repo names. Multiple entries can be included in both lists, whereby black list entries are excluded from aggregation. In the example, the issue lists and a complete overview on the versions is in focus of the project. Running GitHub to Pandas Manager with this configuration creates two datasets that can be analyzed afterwards. We are going to talk about the installation process in several minutes. As you can see, we run two aggregation loops for repository data as well as the mentioned issue data. For our example, I uploaded the resulting two exemplary files into the data folder of our tutorial repository. Take a closer view to the demo projects. As visible in the command line output, we downloaded datasets of four projects. All of them started in 2021, but have different history, number of contributors, or code size. Even at this level, the overview of student repositories can provide important insight. Which features are not or not effectively used and should be presented in an exercise again? My colleagues simulated student activities in a GitHub Classroom example prepared for this tutorial. Many thanks for this. If you are still unsure about using classrooms, you can find more information in the well-made tutorials. Under Linux, the installation process is straightforward. For Windows, please read the instructions in the README file of our project. In both cases, make sure that a Python 3.8 interpreter is installed on your system. Depending on your system configuration, step 1 and 2 in the tabular are probably not necessary. The Python package manager pip and the virtual environment pipenv are used to automate the installation process. By using a virtual environment instead of a global installation, it is much easier to resolve our module's dependencies. The last step is then the actual installation of GitHub to Pandas Manager. This step will deploy GitHub to Pandas and a whole set of other packages in the background. At the end of step 3, you should get the output below in your command line. To access your repositories and those of your students, you have to authorize yourself to GitHub. In the browser, you do this with your password. When using a program to access GitHub content, the token substitutes the password and is sent to the server in the background. There are already many tutorials explaining how to generate the token. I have embedded one example here. Please copy the token as an environment variable to the hidden env file. It is automatically read by the Python interpreter when you start the script. The result should look like the listing below. Don't worry, it's not a valid token for my account. Please remember, we named our classroom GitHub Classroom-Demo. And calls the assignment programming task underscore one. Consequently, we see the following URLs for our simulated student repository collections. GitHub to Pandas Manager, evaluate repository names by already mentioned black and white patterns. Hence, we should aim at the repositories with programming task underscore one minus in name to cover all of our student activities. Be aware that classroom repositories are private in default configuration. For our example, I changed this manually in order to provide a comprehensible example. We transfer this information in the configuration file located in the main folder of our demonstration project. The file should look like the one shown in the listing below after your adaptations. Now we have everything together. The token is stored in an environmental variable, the configuration file is adapted and in the project folder, and the installation process has been completed successfully. Calling the actual script is a bit more complex because we are using the virtual environment. The following listing shows the meaning of each command line parameter. Don't miss to include the minus symbols in front of m and path. Pipenv starts our Python 3 example in the virtual environment. We call the main file of the GitHub to Pandas manager package and pass the configuration file under the given path. If your preparation was successful and you started the script, the output should look like the following listing. Afterward, we have three CSV and pandas data frames available in the examples folder. So what about the results? The team Avengers are highly active and submitted 8 commits, but more important, these colleagues discussed their collaborative work intensively using issues. The team Ofgu just started the task, but did not provide any new version. The commit count is still 1. That means we have only the auto-generated initial commit. None of the teams uses branches, pull requests, or any other feature. Probably we have to revise our teaching strategy related to these things. Let's focus on the significance and clearness of commit messages. Only the author Think Old Current Family from the team Avengers considered the idea of self-explaining messages and added individual information for each commit. By extracting the default message contents, we can supervise this aspect generally and generate statistics that can be used to discuss this in an actual lecture. What are the next steps? We have to extend the data aggregation process by integrating additional elements and improve the robustness of the software. Secondly, it is necessary to adapt and complete the documentation of our project at all levels. And as a last point, we are going to include additional tutorials for the data evaluation process. As a medium-term goal, we aim at an automated feedback system for our students, tutors, and lecturers based on GitHub to Pandas Manager. If you are interested to support this open source project as a developer or as a lecturer with new ideas or requirements, don't hesitate to contact us. Additionally, we are interested in your experiences when using GitHub to Pandas Manager. Looking forward to your feedbacks or questions.